Oh, Hockey 605 here, and we're at the Sioux Falls Flyers Icebreaker Squirt A Tournament. About ready to kick off our second game of the evening with the Lincoln Junior Stars and the Aberdeen Cougars. The Aberdeen Cougars will be the home team, and the Lincoln Junior Stars will be the guest team on the board. Oh, that puck was everywhere but in the net. Aberdeen looking to get the puck out of their end of the ice, but Lincoln Stars are not having that. Nice job there by Dylan Ortmeyer for the Aberdeen Cougars in the goal. He's had his work cut out for him already in this game. Goes in against Ortmeyer. We're 11-12 here in the first period remaining, and the Lincoln Junior Stars have their first goal. We'll listen for the off-ice official to announce who got that goal and who got credited for the Lincoln Stars. Thank you. That goal was by number 66, Jacob Ehlers, number 66 for the Lincoln Junior Stars, assist by number 88, Heath Topol. Just under 11 minutes remaining here in the first period. And the Aberdeen Cougars are getting their first look at the goal. And it was a bit of a glimpse. Got a little bit of a pile up down there. A little bit of glove grabbing. The Aberdeen attack is broken up by the Lincoln Junior Stars. Grant Burbach, number 71, and Rocco DeSpirito, number 1 for the Lincoln Junior Stars, are doing a nice job there shutting down the Aberdeen Cougars. They're going to have to find a way to get through. Want to let you know, folks, that Hockey 605 is social. We're on Facebook. Check out our Facebook page, Hockey 605. We're also on Twitter. It's at Hockey 605 on Twitter. Hope you can join us and be social with us on Hockey 605. A special treat. What? I'll tell you about it in a minute. It's getting a little exciting. Shot on goal by the Cougars and a save by Jacob Morgan for the Lincoln Junior Stars. Between the first and second periods, we're going to be joined by Sebastian Althoff, who is our guest analyst. Sebastian is a Pee-wee player and joined us last weekend to do some game analysis. We're going to chat about the game. He'll join us between the first and second period. Delightful young man and knows his hockey. Good effort there by the Aberdeen Cougars. I think that was number 17 there. Number 17 is Trey Hedges. He's putting a little pressure on the Lincoln Stars goal, and they now are equal, level 3-3 on the shots. But the Stars have a one goal lead, 1-0, with 7:14 remaining in the first.
Oh, and the
Lincoln Stars on a breakaway. Dylan Ortmeyer, goalie for the Cougars, was up to that task and stopped that breakaway. An unmarked player over there. Gonna have to hustle back there. Ethan Russell hustles back.
Stop, John!
Good job there by Ethan Russell for the Aberdeen Cougars. Get back in time to intercept and mess up. Oh, what a shot. What a shot by number 71 for the Flyers. That's Grant Burbach. Sweet shot. 5:45 left in the first. The Flyers are now leading 2-0 over the Aberdeen Cougars. Excuse me, the Lincoln Junior Stars are leading 2-0 over the Aberdeen Cougars. Number 9, Josh Oswald for the Lincoln Junior Stars, was credited with the assist on Grant Burbach's goal. We're glad you could join us for this live squirt hockey action at the Sioux Falls Flyers Icebreaker Tournament, the first Squirt A tournament ever to be held in this beautiful new facility. And we're happy to be a part of the history. Folks, we want to make sure that you understand and know that this puck, all the pucks used in this tournament, have been checked for the right pressure. They all have the proper PSI. And it's a melee in front of the net. Oh, and a shot by the Cougars goes wide. Number 23, Dawson Hepper for the Cougars, is trying to get back one of those goals. Oh, nice work by Lincoln Junior Stars goalie Jacob Morgan. And I don't know if you can hear it in the stands, but I think there's about 60 coaches over here sitting with us, and two or three on the other side with the players. Let's go ahead and acknowledge those coaches. For the Aberdeen Cougars, we have Jared Alberg-Head, John Dabney, Jason Jorgensen, Chris Fike, Quentin Nyman, Troy Nyman, Doug Coughlin, Jay Kleinkeck, Klein Connect, and Angelica Gold. I'm sure they're not all there right now. We'll catch up with the Lincoln coaches here in a few minutes. .329 remaining here in this first period. A reminder that Sebastian Althoff will be joining me here between the first and second period while they Zamboni the ice. And we'll talk about the first period here and see what Sebastian thinks. Pretty close game so far. And the race is on. Who's going to get there first? Always the puck.
Come on, man. Get in there.
If you're enjoying this game at home, folks, we hope that any comments that you're directing at the screen to the players are all positive, because sportsmanship does matter. Even though we can't hear you, we'd like to think you're giving the kids all kinds of positive support. And we had another scrum down there in front of the net. Dylan Ortmeyer kept it out again. You know, Aberdeen has a tradition going on that they've got with their goalies. They have the top two goalies in the boys' varsity side of their program this year, and I believe both of the top two positions in the girls' varsity side are also from Aberdeen. So Dylan has some good role models to follow there. Another nice save by Dylan Ortmeyer. He is certainly up to the task. Shot clock, the shots are pretty equal right now. Lincoln has 7, Aberdeen has 6. Oh, and Dylan's probably saying, get that puck out from behind me. Oh, 30 seconds in the period. And we have icing. An icing call against the Cougars. Oh. And the Stripes will take it back down to the other end. We'll have a face-off here. We're under 20 seconds now remaining in this first period. I'm not sure what the official saw there, but Stop play, and here we go. Aberdeen would certainly like to get one goal in there before this period ends. That was a golden opportunity for him, but denied by Jacob Morgan, goalie for the Lincoln Junior Stars. And that's the end of the first period, folks. We'll watch the kids head off the ice while we get set up for our game analysis with Sebastian Altoff. We'll be right back with you. Check. All right, here we are. Introduce you to Sebastian Altoff, who is a Pee Wee player. We met last weekend, and you helped us out with some game analysis last weekend and in the first game tonight, didn't you?
Yep.
Are you having fun doing it, Sebastian?
Oh, definitely. It's a blast.
Well, and it's fun for us because you're a player, and you know what's going on out there on the ice way better than we do, and you can relate to what the guys are going through, can't you?
A little bit, yeah.
Well, what do you think of this game so far?
It's closer than the scoreboard shows. I mean, obviously, or honestly, it, through my eyes, this is only a one-goal game.
Yeah, I would have to agree with you.
That first goal that Lincoln scored was just a lucky bounce off of Dylan's shoulder, so.
And that happens, doesn't it?
That's right.
It's not all about skill. Sometimes it's having luck on your side.
Definitely.
Well, they're level. They both have 7 shots on goal. I would say the quality of shots perhaps have been a little bit better for Lincoln Junior Stars. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I'd agree with that. I mean, I think Aberdeen has given Lincoln some better chances. Like, Lincoln has been played a bit more defensively. But
yeah. Well, and Dylan Ortmeyer, the goalie for Aberdeen, has been doing a pretty darn good job.
He looks like a pro.
I know. Well, I was talking about it during the live stream. I don't know if you could hear me, but they've got some really great goalies up there in Aberdeen. I think for both the boys and the girls varsity teams, the top 2 goalies with the fewest goals allowed, the highest save percentage, are both from Aberdeen.
You know, I remember back when I was a mite on the C team and we played Aberdeen up in Aberdeen, and their goalie I thought was literally like on the varsity team. Like, we beat them that game, but I remember thinking we only won because, like, I remember thinking when we won, we really just beat their goalie, that's all.
Finally.
Yeah, finally.
So, you know, you were just playing this division last year. How old were you when you played this division last year?
Last year I was 11.
So, this age division is pretty much 10 and 11 year olds?
Yep.
And do you ever listen to the parents in the stands when you're playing? Not necessarily your parents.
No, my parents aren't that loud or vocal, but I mean, some of them do get loud and sometimes they get annoying, but.
Can you hear them through the plexiglass?
Yeah, definitely. But I mean, it's only when they get really annoying that you notice them.
Yeah. Well, and you know, I used to think that plexiglass was to protect the spectators from pucks flying. But now I think it might be to protect you guys from hearing the parents sometimes.
Maybe.
Well, these guys have been pretty good, but sometimes I wonder how that impacts on the ice when you hear parents getting too wound up, especially when you're putting pressure on 10 and 11-year-old guys, right?
Yeah, I've seen some players get mad at parents. I know when I filled in for a goalie one time, I hated it because, well, I didn't hate it. I loved it, but I hated parts of it because the parents, and they'd be right behind me yelling at me, and I hated that. Like, it's horrible, but.
Wow, and that happened last year?
Yeah, first tournament last year.
Wow, and to have people yelling at 10 and 11-year-old kids is kind of silly, isn't it?
A little bit, yeah.
Well, these parents have been pretty darn good, though, I think, don't you?
I agree. I think last game and this game, both of the parents are good. I think part of that is the reffing is good. I mean, I don't think there's a single penalty yet today.
No, I think they're playing good, clean hockey out there. They're making some contact, but hockey is a contact sport, right?
Yeah, honestly, I was down in the corner videoing some of the game down from there, And when you get close, you see pushing and shoving, but the refs don't see that, and that's part of hockey. So.
Well, a little pushing and shoving is part of what happens.
Definitely, yeah. I love doing it.
Yeah, well, getting out there and claiming your own little piece of territory, right?
Right.
Well, these guys are doing a great job. Now, what would you say if you're the Aberdeen coach? What would you be saying to them in the locker room right now?
I'd just be giving words of encouragement. I mean, they're still in this game. It's not like it's 6-goal lead like we had last game. It's a 2-goal lead. I remember, if I were the Lincoln coach, I remember something that Coach Carlson told me last year, that a 2-goal lead is the hardest to keep. And that game we ended up losing too, so.
Yeah, a 2-goal lead, you think you got a cushion, and then pretty soon you're down. It can be 2-1, then you can be tied, and then you can be down, right?
Right, 1 goal equals a 1-goal game, so.
Yep. Well, this, and like you said, this game feels like a 1-goal game.
Definitely, yeah, just luck has it, so.
All right, well, we're going to wrap it up, Sebastian, and we'll be back between the second and third period for a very brief update. We'll probably just leave the camera on the ice for that one, but we'll talk a little bit about that, what we see in the second period. For now, we're going to turn it over to the ZamCam. Thanks for joining Sebastian and I here for a little game analysis between the first and second period. It's 2-0, and we got about 10 minutes left. So enjoy the ZamCam. Want to say bye?
See ya.
And we're back, folks. If the voice that you're hearing is a little bit deeper than you're used to, you've got a substitute announcer here for a few minutes. Been a good game so far, pretty evenly played. Boys are all trying hard and a lot of good sportsmanship going on. We're always happy to see that and happy to see that everybody in the crowds are behaving themselves. Make sure if you get an opportunity to go find Hockey 605 on Facebook and you want to make sure and like us on the Facebook page, because of course everybody likes to get liked, but we are having a lot of fun there on the Hockey 605 Facebook page, and you should be part of it. For you folks in Aberdeen who are watching tonight, you want to make sure and tune in. Unless you can make the game in Brookings, we have the clash of two undefeated programs tomorrow. We'll be live streaming the girls junior varsity game at 6 p.m. and we'll be live streaming the varsity girls at 8. Should be a fantastic couple of games for you folks to be checking in on. So we look forward to seeing you on Hockey 605 tomorrow night. Looks like we're having an equipment issue down there with Mr. Morgan. Pretty good contingent here from our friends up in Aberdeen. In addition to the game that we're doing tomorrow night, we will be at Aberdeen doing one of the state tournaments here a little bit later on. I think it's the one of the Bantam tournaments. And Hockey 605 will be there bringing that to all the folks out there. Okay, looks like they have Jacob Morgan's gear put together and time to play a little hockey. Second period, folks. And here we go.
Well, Aberdeen gets one back. We'll find out in just a minute here who's getting credited with that goal and assist. Great hockey action here at the Sioux Falls Flyers icebreaker score day. Goal by number 12, Maddox May. I believe that was at 13:47 of the second period. And another shot there by number 23, Dawson Hepper. And the race is on. Puck one, player zero there. There's one in for Lincoln Junior Stars. Very deep in that heap is the goal scorer there. We'll get his number here in a minute. If you're watching at home, you probably already know who it is. That's number 66, Jacob Ehlers.
Go Cougars!
Back to a two-goal differential, 12:07 on the clock. Lincoln Junior Stars are up 3-1 again on Aberdeen Cougars. Jacob Ehlers, of course, is credited with scoring that goal unassisted. Another Lincoln attack down there. Nice passing by the Junior Stars. Interception. Nobody there to receive the pass. Trey Hedges came back for it. And is rewarded with another touch on the puck. I believe that was going to be an offside call. Just under 11 minutes remaining here in this second period of action. The Squirt A Icebreaker Tournament at the beautiful Shields Iceplex. This is the inaugural Squirt A tournament here for the Sioux Falls tourney hockey. And just the third tournament overall to be held here. Last weekend was the Pee Wee A tournament. A couple weeks before that was the Squirt BC tournament. And that's probably going to be icing. Folks, we want to do a shout out to some of the people that make it possible for us to bring you these live stream games. I want to thank Home Federal Bank. Home Federal Bank, great supporters of youth sports. Home Federal Bank reminds you that it's your time to shine. And a shout out to Bert Post and the folks at Hockey Headquarters. Hockey Headquarters is there and ready to help you meet your hockey goals. We have another icing call. You may have noticed on the dasher boards we have some of the sponsors who make live stream possible. And we also have a banner on there called Nate's Heart. Nate Wick is a Pee Wee player from here in Sioux Falls who collapsed on Monday evening. Actually Monday afternoon at school at basketball tryouts. Nate is now in Iowa City undergoing tests to see what happened, what caused him to go into cardiac arrest. He's got a tough road ahead of him. Nate, we're thinking of you, buddy, and of your folks. If you'd like to help out Nate's family, you can click on the banner, Nate's Heart, on there, and go to Nate's Heart GoFundMe program and contribute what you feel you can, folks, for helping the Wick family with what will undoubtedly be some tremendous out-of-pocket expenses as Nate fights back to recover and get back on the ice again soon. And we know they'll always appreciate your best wishes and prayers. again, offside was called by one of the parents in the stands, and evidently the referee agreed with him. Had a lot of fun having Sebastian Althoff join us for game analysis between the periods, and he'll be back with us again between the second and third for a very short update on our analysis. What a great game. He's 10 and 11-year-old guys are out there giving it everything they've got. And of course, this is Squirt. There can be girls on these teams as well, but I'm not sure with those uniforms if there are any girls out there. But these Squirt players are giving you a highly entertaining game. Nice shot there. What a shot. I don't think Dylan Ortmeyer stood a chance against that shot. That shot was by number 19, Thomas Hermel. Thomas Hermel, and it is 8:23 remaining on the clock as the Lincoln Junior Stars pull ahead 4-1. Still 10-9 on the shots. Pretty even on the number of shots. Number 3, Jackson Beach, is credited with the assist on that Thomas Hermel goal. Number 4 for the Lincoln Junior Stars. Oh, nice save there by the Lincoln goalie. Sometimes you gotta sacrifice the body. And that appears to be what Maddox May just did there. Oh, almost. Aberdeen defenseman get in the way of that shot. And gather up the puck to launch their own counterattack. The Lincoln Stars defensemen are doing a nice job of staying home and keeping the puck from getting in their end very much this period. Just over 6 minutes remaining here in the second period. And an opportunity here for Aberdeen. Yep. Offsides against the Cougars. It's been some great hockey action here this evening in the Squirt A tournament. We're down to less than 5 minutes left in the second period of the second game, and there have been no penalty minutes on the night. These kids are playing a nice, clean game and playing hard, just as they did in the earlier game. And the puck takes a hard bounce off the boards. Oh, nice effort there. Good pressure there that the Aberdeen Cougars are. Lincoln Junior Stars goal. There it is. That paid off for him. All right. Love to see him rewarded for that hard work. I believe that goal was scored by number 22, Austin Dabney, but we'll hear in a minute here from the off-ice officials, and we'll share that with you. So it's back to a two-goal game with 2:44 left. Shots are still pretty equal. 12 shots on goal for the Aberdeen Cougars, 10 shots on goal for the Lincoln Junior Stars. Nice stop by Ortmeier. Dawson Hepper heading down on the attack. And he's followed up by Trey Hedges, who's joining him there. And Jacob Grau. Oh, we have an offsides. Number 10, Jaden Jorgensen for the Cougars, fires the puck down. It's covered by Jacob Morgan, goalie for the Lincoln Junior Stars. A bit of a line change going on for Lincoln now. Yeah, just over 2 minutes, 2:06 to be exact, left in this second period. I want to remind you that we'll be joined again by Sebastian Althoff here between periods for some more game analysis. This is an exciting game, folks. I'm glad you could join us tonight. I believe that found the back of the net, despite efforts by Dylan Ortmeyer. 1:21 remaining in the second period. Lincoln Junior Stars are up 5-2. We'll see who's going to get the credit for that goal. That goal was scored by number 3, I believe they said, Jackson Beach. And I believe they said the assist was by number 71, Grant Burbach. We're down to under a minute remaining in this period of the game. And a Lincoln shot goes wide. And the next one is saved by Dylan Ortmeyer as he catches the puck. We're down to 10 seconds, 10.7 remaining in the second period. And the Cougars clear the puck out. And that'll be the end of the second period. The Lincoln Junior Stars have 14 shots on goal to 13 for the Aberdeen Cougars, but the Lincoln Junior Stars have put 5 of their shots in the back of the net compared to 2 for the Aberdeen Cougars. Now we're going to be joined here, as I mentioned, we're going to hook up here with All right. Well, here we are, Sebastian. What did you think of this game here, this second period?
You know, Lincoln's pulling ahead, so.
Yeah, they're pulling ahead. It was a 2-goal game. Now it's a 3-goal game. They've just been taking a lot more shots than they were earlier, but the shots are still even.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of surprising, honestly, the score. I think this game is really going to come down to goaltending, honestly.
Yeah. Well, that's a good point. Both goalies are having their work cut out for them. Ortmeyer's doing a great job, but he's going to need a little more help in front of his net.
Definitely, yeah. There's been a couple own goals, so that's never fun. And, you know, that honestly tears your team down. So.
All right. Well, it's time to get back to the game. Thanks a lot. We'll catch up with you tomorrow or Sunday, I guess. Tomorrow you have some games of your own, right?
Yeah, so.
All right. Thanks a lot for all your help tonight. We appreciate your feedback and your analysis, Sebastian.
Yeah, let's go see how this game ends.
All right, let's do it. Very quick analysis there with Sebastian. Have to watch the game and see. Oh, it's starting to get it. The margin is widening with another goal by the Lincoln Junior Stars at 13:45 of the third period. We'll see who got credited with that goal. Number 66, Jacob Ehlers, is credited with that goal. I believe that's his second of the night. These young referees are doing a fine job out here calling this game. You know, we can play the game without parents. We can even play the game without coaches. They can line themselves up, but we can't play the game without referees. Have you hugged an official today? We need to give him some appreciation and encourage more players to try their hand at officiating. An opportunity for us to do a shout out to and thank you to Bargain Bites. Bargain Bites of Sioux Falls, one of our sponsors for the live stream games. Shot across the mouth of the goal. That one goes just short. Some of the Cougars are starting to get a little tired here. I think that's one of the differences you'll see between having two lines and three lines. Lincoln has three full lines and Aberdeen has just two. Of course, when you only have two lines, everybody gets plenty of skate time. Dylan Ortmeyer drops and covers and protects his goal. Ethan Russell for the Flyers, excuse me, for Aberdeen Cougars, broke that up a little bit there. Bud Lincoln is back down on another relentless attack here. We're at 9:21 remaining in the third period. Lincoln Junior Stars are up 6-2 over the Aberdeen Cougars. And there we go. There we go. There's an Aberdeen goal. And that was scored by number 17. That guy right there, Trey Hedges. He's been working hard all game, and finally it paid off for him. Gates a little celebration circle. That's at 9:07 remaining in the third period. We're back to a three-goal game. Lincoln 6, Aberdeen 3. I may have miscalculated when I said they were tired earlier. That goal brought a real spark back to these Cougars. Oh. Jacob Grau and Philip Zenz were doing a nice job down there, creating opportunities and chances for the Cougars. Nice block there by Dylan Ortmeyer. That'll be icing. And another line change for the Lincoln Junior Stars coming in. .734 remaining here in the third period. A nice shot. But no reward. Blocked by Jacob Morgan for the Lincoln Junior Stars. He's doing a nice job there between the pipes. Casey Claymore for Aberdeen was working down there to get a shot off. Went wide of the net. Kyle Catherall, number 15 for the Lincoln Junior Stars, is doing a nice job protecting the puck, but it's back up there. Just over 5 minutes remaining here in the third period, 5 minutes remaining in the game. Lincoln Junior Stars lead 6-3 over Aberdeen Cougars. Cougars have 17 shots on goal at this point in the game. Lincoln have 16 shots on goal. And that's an offsides foul against the Lincoln Junior Stars. Shot just wide. Nice stop there by Dylan Ortmeyer. We're at 3:38 remaining in this Icebreaker Squirt A tournament at the Iceplex with the Sioux Falls Flyers. First Squirt A tournament at the Iceplex. You're watching the Aberdeen Cougars and the Lincoln Junior Stars. And an icing call against the Lincoln Junior Stars. 2:31 remaining here in the third period. Lincoln Junior Stars are up 6-3 over the Aberdeen Cougars. Equal shots, 17 apiece on goal. Game will be done here in a few minutes, folks, but if you're still up for some hockey action, you can stay right here. We'll be bringing you a varsity boys game with the Sioux Falls Flyers East and Sioux Falls Flyers West. And that game starts at 8:30. We'll be joined by the Shields Iceplex General Operations Manager, Brian Prisby, who will be color man along with our own Randy McKee on Hockey 605. And they'll be announcing the game and bringing it to you live. I encourage you to stay with us here on Hockey 605. It'll be live at Shields Iceplex, but you will need to refresh your browser when this game is over because it will be a new live stream that we'll be putting up there. Thank you. Nice job there by the Aberdeen defenseman. Oh, nice deflection there by Ortmeyer to prevent another goal from getting in the back of his net. One minute remaining. We'll be back here tomorrow morning for more Squirt A icebreaker action. Hope you're able to join us. If you can't be at the rink, you can watch it on Hockey 605. We'll be here for all the games Saturday morning. And then back again Sunday morning for the championship. Just under 15 seconds remaining in this game. And that's game. Lincoln Junior Stars take this one home, 6-3 over the Aberdeen Cougars. A great game. Good effort on the part of every player on the ice. Kudos to the referees, for the officials, for doing such a great job officiating the game. And to both coaches, all coaches, for a well-coached game, and to our off-ice officials, taking care of the scoreboard, taking care of the shots on goal, and all of the stats. And we didn't have anything that we had to worry about with the guys who were sitting there in the box, because there were no penalties in this game or the previous one. That's hockey sportsmanship. That's hockey strong. Thanks again for joining us, folks. We'll be back here with you tomorrow. And if you'd like, stay tuned for the varsity game. It'll be coming up at 8:30 Central Time. The Sioux Falls Flyers East versus the Sioux Falls Flyers West. Adios. See you tomorrow.